Well, that was good timing, the train coming by there. Oh, it's awful windy. I hope the wind is not in that microphone too bad. I'll point the camera this way. Boy, it's just been so rainy these past few days, and today the sun came out a little bit, as you can see. And again, if I turn the camera on, it's gonna be windy, but that low-lying mist hanging on the mountains here. I'm in between my house and one of my elementary schools. The elementary school is over that way, and my house is about, if you walked from here, about 5 minutes from here. And I just thought I'd turn on the camera. The rains came so much, the level on this river really rose. Normally it's very low. Closest elementary school. Some of you asked me, like, how far away. So my house, I don't know if you can see those cars up on that road. Basically, you go down that road and then around a few corners, and my apartment is just over there. And this elementary school, as you can see, is just over yonder. So it's my closest school. It's about, to bike, like 3 minutes, to walk, maybe 10 minutes, in my car, obviously 2 minutes. And I go there once a week. It's a small school. I mean, it's kind of what I consider a medium-sized elementary. There's only one homeroom per grade, and each homeroom has 20 to 25 kids. So, smaller. You know, what's that, about 150 kids total. And then tomorrow I'm off to one of my biggest elementary schools that has about double that number, about 300 kids. So I just wanted to show you the rice too, how it's kind of grown up just since that last video I made called Baby Rice. And you can kind of see. Out, and this is definitely the Inaka. I mean, some of you will be coming from fairly small places. I've been getting a lot of emails from you guys about your placements, and I will make that placement video soon. Some of you will come from fairly small towns, so this won't be that big a change, although I'm assuming that most of you went to college in some somewhat large environment. So it's not like you've been all your life in a very small town like my town here. I think the major thing is your perception of Japan. Certainly when I came, and I think I talked about this in one of my Tokyo videos, I thought all of Japan was very modern, very urban, and kind of like, you know, you see in the movies, and what you see in the movies tends to a lot be Osaka or Tokyo. And it just never occurred to me that living in Japan meant living out here in the countryside like this. And the reality, of course, as I've emphasized over and over and over again with you guys, is that most jets get placed in very rural environments. Not all of you. I mean, some of you have emailed me and said you're going to be an hour outside of Kyoto, or an hour outside of Osaka, or you're going to be in Chiba-ken, you know, or somewhere close to Tokyo. And so that's great, you know. But the simple fact is that most of you won't. Most of you will be in very rural environments. And, you know, I'm going to do some videos soon about adjusting to life back in America. Many of you keep asking, you know, what are you going to do? So I can't, you know, I can't say for certain everything that's going to happen after my job with Jet finishes, but for sure, oh, that wind, for sure I am going home. There's some things going on at home that I need to go and be there for, and so I think it's a good break for me. And I don't want to leave Japan, but it's as good a time as any to take a break and go back to the States. I really do hope to hopefully come back in 2010, and of course I'll keep you all posted, but for now, I definitely am flying home at the end of July, the beginning of August, back to San Diego. But I should have tons of footage to keep posting and lots to still talk about. And I'm getting a fairly good response to the teaching, you know, the talking about being a teacher videos. So of course I can easily continue those from America. And hey, I'll be upgrading my parents. I bought them a nice new desktop Mac a few years ago as a Christmas present. So I'll be getting their nice spiffy new webcam and everything that goes along with their really nice Mac computer. So maybe my videos will even be spiffier. Oh, it's so windy, but it feels good. It's been so hot before it rained. Anyway, okay, so yeah, you know, if you're expecting to come and it to be like Tokyo and you're gonna be a jet, it's not. It's just not. Some of you will be in, you know, I mean, some people, I'm gonna be posting a video, actually probably before this one, with an interview with Regina and Liz, and they both live in the capital, Matsue, and while it's not a big city by American standards, it's still a city. There's still, you know, lots of conveniences. They're not out in the rural, they're not surrounded by rice fields like I am. And I'm not even as Inaka as some people in Shimane are, who are really much more cut off from daily conveniences. I mean, I can get in my car and drive 10 minutes and, you know, be at a fairly good selection of restaurants, a few grocery stores, an electronics store, video rental shops, you know, all that kind of stuff is very close by, so I can't complain at all. As I've told you many times, I love where I live. I think I got very, very lucky with my placement. Okay, so the rice is growing. I have about a month left in Japan, and about 5 weeks. And of course, I will keep posting, and if you guys keep watching, it's all good. So thanks. See ya.